Yeah. Sometimes we laugh and sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now. Baby, I took a half and she took the whole thing and slow down. Baby, we took a trip, now we on your block and it's like a ghost town.
Baby,
where do these be at when they say they doing all this and all that?
Hello, today I am here with the lovely Sam Cox, who is a defensive midfielder for Hampton and Richmond FC. He's represented the Guyana national team and he's also now coaching at Spurs. Thank you for coming on.
Thank you for having me.
So, Vasily, how are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Yeah,
I'm good.
Good. Are you excited to play me a game of FIFA? What's the sitch?
Well, I'm going to be honest, I haven't played FIFA since 2011. So, yeah, this
are you
is going
to be interesting. Are you just saying this to kind of throw me off and then... You actually haven't played for, what, 10
years?
I'm
going to be honest, yeah, probably about that.
That's secretly exciting.
That's why you're having me on the interview, just so you could actually...
No, that secretly excites me, because now maybe I won't lose another episode.
Well, we'll see.
Or it would just be worse, because I'll still end up losing with my track record.
Oh, dear.
But, okay, this should be a good one then. Let's go. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Ish.
Ish. You'll be fine. You'll be
the graphics look so good these days, don't they? What is this, 2020?
What was the last one you had?
2011.
You're kidding.
No, I stopped buying it when I stopped being on the game.
No, you didn't.
I did.
Those petty levels.
I was petty, yeah.
Oh, hi.
Exactly that.
And I made you a FIFA.
Hey, I'm on there. That's Marcelo.
He's got the same hair.
He has.
I made you a FIFA player, so you can be...
I can be me.
Yeah. And you can...
Dream come true.
Do you know what I mean? Here I am, making dreams come true. And... Yeah, and I put you
on Spurs. I love that.
Because that's where you started your playing career. You're
exactly.
Coaching there now.
Exactly.
So I thought, you know.
Am I really rubbish though?
No, you're good. You're, what's it called? Stat.
Oh my, I'm playing as well.
See?
I'm playing centre mid as well. And I've got the long hair, old school, cane rose.
Yeah, exactly. For the old days, eh?
For the old days. It's when my hairline was strong.
So, talk to me. I want to know everything. Tell me about your football journey and how you've got to where you are.
This is really hard, trying to play FIFA and concentrate on the questions. I've been playing football as long as I can remember. Huge influence from my dad and mum, to be honest. Like, my dad's a big football fan and he got me into it. And...
Sorry, Sam, I feel like you definitely, you had me on this whole time.
No, it's not hard.
All the build up to this interview, you're like, I'm so bad. Have I had the ball yet? Once? No.
Bosh. I think I might have. You're not playing your best, are you?
Do you know what?
You're trying to make me feel good.
I'm embarrassed that you've said that because I was trying my best. So yes, your family, dad's a huge fan.
Dad got me into football. And it's funny because... he used to take me over the park and they used to try and get me to play and go on the grass and, you know,
used
to go in goal and stuff. But I actually never used to want to go on the grass because I never used to want to get my feet dirty.
No. So I think your dad's dream
he used to be fuming. I remember him being so disappointed in me.
Oh.
He'll never be a footballer as long as his ass looks down. So he used to say.
No, he didn't.
Did. Funny enough,
brilliant.
20 years later, all I do now is get dirty and... I'm usually the dirtiest player on the pitch.
Oh, and I bet your dad's like your number one fan now.
He is. To be fair, he goes to all the games and, you know, he tries to support me home and away. And, you know, I can't ask anything more. And
of course,
support I've had from my family has been second to none. So, it's dirty, you.
I've got to get it somehow. You've literally just been passing between your players for God knows how long.
I was doing okay at grassroots level, Sunday league. I played for a club called Watling Boys. In Burnt Oak, and I found out as the games went on that I was actually quite okay at football, and I started to attract scouts from, you know, certain academies, and not before long I was trialing at Watford, Arsenal, Fulham. Never got into any of them though.
No,
so I experienced quite a lot of rejection from clubs at a young age.
And how did you find that in terms of staying motivated to like really chase your dream?
It was fine, you know, because my mum and dad always said, you know, use it as experience. And yes. I was so grateful just for the opportunity. Even as a kid, like, I didn't really see it as it was do or die that I had to, you know, get into these academies. It was just, you know, give my best.
Yeah, that's what
you. And if something came of it, then, you know, brilliant.
And it probably made you stronger.
1,000%. And, you know, getting that experience at an academy, now various academies from the age of, you know, 9 to 14, helped me massively by the time I got to 14. And, you know, the opportunity came to go into Tottenham. And that's quite late to go into an academy like Tottenham.
Yes.
I kind of had, you know, one eye on going into education because I thought, you know, it's getting late in the day.
Yeah.
Oh, Sam Cox with a header.
How funny would that be?
Hey.
Looks good, doesn't it?
That doesn't look bad at all. You've done a good job, to be fair.
Thank you. Thank you. I try.
Then I went on to some development centre games at Tottenham, got brought into the academy for a 6-week trial, and the rest was history, as they say.
Oh my gosh. And I obviously know that you are back there now. You're coaching the youth club?
Correct. The youth club.
The youth team.
The youth club. Tottenham Youth Club. I think that's down Seven Sisters. Have you beat anyone so far?
No.
Mm.
I've taken an L every single episode. So I really thought...
This was your chance. This still is your chance. I mean, it's 0-0. 31 minutes gone.
Yeah. I just want to win, like, properly with a goal, you know?
Is that why you asked me onto the interview?
Yeah, there's any reason. Just for a morale boost.
Oh, no. That's why you got me on here, isn't it?
I know.
No. I feel kind of snaked.
Don't be silly. No. Out. No.
There we go. It's the first goal I've scored since 2011. It's a good goal.
I don't know if it's something.
It's a good goal.
I don't know if it's something you can even brag about because it's against me.
Listen, you played more games than I have.
Yeah, that's the worrying part, Sam, and I'm still dread. Yeah,
Sonny. Yeah. Like that. It's good playing this one. Anyway,
what did you say? Trying to make me feel better.
So, you are back at Spurs coaching the youth team.
Yeah.
If he gets one goal and you get muggy, yeah?
I am, but I've got the... So, I'm working back at the academy now.
Yes.
Obviously, you know, a place that I consider home. And, you know, Tottenham have been so good to me. You know, John McDermott especially, who's now working for England as director of football. He was...
Oh, wow.
He's been so influential in my career and, you know, even dropping down the Football League pyramid. He was always in contact and asking me, you know, what I'm up to. And when that time came, when I dropped down into non-league, he said, did I want to come in and do a bit of coaching? Which I did. For the last 3 or 4 years, I've been with the under-15s now, working with Bradley Allen, who actually was one of the guys that signed me when I was at the club as a 14-15-year-old.
No way! That must be so weird for you,
man. Yeah, I've done the full circle now. So, you know, I think this would be my 13th season at the club.
Amazing. And obviously you've had a lot of achievements in your football career.
Thank you.
All the awards you've won, all the games you've played. Tell me, what would you say has been your highlight?
Harry Kane.
I should have made you a worse team, shouldn't I? That's why I messed up.
I'm not bad at this game.
10 years later.
I might have to buy myself a PlayStation at work.
Yeah, you'll finally buy FIFA again, thanks to me. But yes, your highlights.
My highlights of my career?
Yeah.
I'd probably say most recent, going to the Gold Cup with Guyana,
yes,
the national team.
Yes, of course.
That was probably like my highlight. And you know, something at my age, playing non-league where I've been playing the last couple of years, I didn't think I would get an opportunity like that. And to represent the country, to captain the country at a world major tournament. Yeah, it was almost surreal. My mum and dad actually flew over to America as well, where it was.
Oh,
it's just a surreal experience, even looking back at the footage now and looking back at some of the pictures. You always have to pinch yourself because, yeah, you don't expect those things, but it just shows, you know, you stay in the game long enough and try your best and apply yourself, then you just don't know what's around the corner. So,
I think you definitely lived every player's dream at representing your country. So well done you.
Yeah, it's something that I'll always be proud of. We were the first side in our country's history to go to a major tournament. We're in the prelims for the Gold Cup 2021. So, yeah, we just hope to build on that and get further next time.
You're the captain.
Well, hopefully I get there.
you will, after last time.
Yeah, you made so me hard. Ugly, didn't you?
No, you look cute.
You made me ugly.
No. Right, second half, are you ready?
Let's go. 2-0.
I can't believe
Spurs.
It, Sam.
Listen, it's been a long time, but as they say, you never lose. Oh, you're right, mate. He's bored. He's off.
He's had enough of you.
He's had enough. Oh, to be fair.
Surely that's a foul.
Don't blame him.
He's actually had enough. Right, so tell me, we just had a lockdown, crazy stuff going on in the world. How did you find that? What did you get up to?
I mean, for me, I saw lockdown as an opportunity to explore new things. I stayed busy. I stayed proactive.
Good. That was quite hard for a lot of people to stay productive and motivated, you know.
100%. I mean, for me, living on my own, I just tried to train as much as I can. I was out, running every day. And
right.
I came back to pre-season probably in the best condition I've been in the last 10 years. So that was a positive. I also grew my hair for charity, as you can see.
Yes, I know about this.
I grew my hair for charity, yeah. So it's
so lovely.
Yeah, it's been 10 years, I mean, since my mum went into hospital. And
the NHS saved her life, basically. She was in coma for 7 weeks, in ICU for a couple of months. So, I mean, I know for a chance to give back to the NHS, I thought, what better way to raise money than to do the opposite to what I'd done before. I cut my hair off, as we've made here on this game. I had a long cane rose, but yeah.
So you'd go the other way.
It was actually one of my mates' dads, Callum Butcher. He messaged me on Facebook. He said, "Great."
Right.
He said, "Grow the plaques back." I said, "I'll do it if you do it to charity." He said, "Sure, no problem." He said, "I'll be the first to sponsor you."
No way.
He just went from there, and he ended up making about $6,000, which was
Sam, it's amazing.
Which is brilliant. So.
So, yeah, no, that was good. And also I'd done my Instagram lives over lockdown as well, which went down really well. So, you know, something that I've always been interested in going to with media, as you're doing now.
Yeah.
Absolutely smashing it.
Oh, bless you.
So, I got little chats with some really top people. And
I literally love your little chat shows.
I hadn't spoken to Jermaine Genius for ages, since I was a kid at Spurs, really. So to connect with people like him and Jeremy Lynch,
to a lot of top boys, haven't
you? I had some really good guests, and you know, but yeah
and you have to look at the silver linings with these kind of things, because obviously lockdown has meant that you can kind of just take a step back and do things that you probably wouldn't have had the time for.
100%.
If this had happened.
I'll tell you something. I'll tell you, well, not so funny for me.
Oh, no.
I think it was the second week of lockdown.
Right.
And obviously TikTok was going crazy, right?
Of course. Were you on, did you jump on the hype, the TikTok hype?
I didn't. I was really bad.
Right.
And it's funny because I'm okay at dancing, but I'd still to this day, I couldn't tell you how you work a video.
I feel like I need to teach you now.
I would love to learn.
All right, we'll do a TikTok after the game.
So, second week of lockdown, yeah? And I've been issued a challenge by Omar Beckles.
Right.
He's doing a new edition. It was a new edition. You will not remember New Edition.
No.
But they were
you're showing your age now.
A little bit. They were an R&B group. Unbelievable. And Omar Beckles issued me a New Edition challenge, dance challenge.
I put my phone on the side. I literally got my new iPhone 11 Pro before lockdown, literally a week before. Put it on the side now. The video would never come out. I'd never show anyone. I'm dancing now, doing my thing.
Trying to do the TikTok. Right.
The phone's fallen off the edge and absolutely shattered everywhere.
Smashed the screen.
Trying to do
a TikTok. No matter, you never went back.
So I went without a phone for a week.
Gosh. So
terrible.
That was your first ever and probably last TikTok experience.
Oh, 100%. I never applied to another challenge after that.
Please tell me you still have the video.
I do, but you'll never see it.
Why is that? I want an exclusive right here on game day.
I don't swear, but I'm pretty sure if you play that video back, you'll hear a few swear words with a shattered screen at the end.
Like after you just got your new phone as well. Wait, so you obviously said you like dancing and all that and media. Would you have gone into that if you weren't a footballer? What would be like your dream second job?
Dream second job would be probably acting. My dream second job would be acting. Yeah, I'd say so.
Stop.
Yeah, or like the lead singer of a band.
What band? Choose one band from forever. Old or new, what band would you be in?
I'd be Michael Jackson, the Jackson 5.
I love it.
Stop, I feel like I definitely need to get a...
No.
What do you mean no?
No. I said
what do you mean? You can't come on here telling me you like singing, acting, dancing, TikToking.
Drawing.
And not give me...
Drawing.
I like drawing.
See, all these little fun facts about you.
I like creative stuff. I would definitely have a job like being creative.
In the arts, yeah. What do you draw on?
Cartoons. Caricatures.
Can I have one?
Sure.
Can you give me a
Serena
or
see
a caricature next time I see
100%.
You?
No problem.
I love it. I'm sick.
Consider it. I just
won
the game, by the way.
Yeah, do you know what,
Sam? I'm so done with it.
I don't blame you.
I'm so done with it because I actually thought I stood a chance by what you were saying at the beginning, and I still took the L as if.
Yeah, to be honest, like I said, I haven't played for nearly 10 years, and it was quite a comprehensive win. I was bad and still beat you 2-0. But it's fine.
But you can't get any stick from anyone now or be ripped apart because you still won. So
I'm going to end my FIFA career on a 2-0 win now, I think. Don't need to play ever again. I'm good.
You're still retired from the FIFA, yeah?
I came out of retirement like Mike Tyson came out for one fight, one go, one now.
There you go.
I'm done out here.
Codes is actually loving you. He's sat like that the whole time.
Is he like this with everyone, though?
No, do you know what, Sam? He's not. He's not, so you should feel honoured. Feel honoured. Right, are you ready for a game of 1v1?
1v1, let's go.
Yeah, so I'm going to give you two options, and you just have to say which one out of the two you prefer.
Sweet, let's go.
Singing or dancing?
Oh, that's a hard first question.
I know, exactly. Now I know you from the interview.
Both,
okay. Come on, choose one.
Depends what day it is.
Fair enough. Mm. Yeah, okay. Cats or dogs?
Dogs, obviously.
Do you hear that, Coates? 60s music or 90s?
I ain't that bloody old. 60s, you know. 90s, of course.
Did you not just say Jackson 5 in the interview? Come on. Is that
they
the
weren't 60s?
Yeah, they were.
70s?
No, they weren't.
Mainly.
Really? I can't argue with you. You're older than me. Okay. Drake or Lil Baby?
Drake, yeah,
okay.
100%.
Sweets or chocolate?
Vegan, sweets.
Oh, of course.
Yeah.
Jeans or tracksuits?
Jeans.
Really?
1000%.
I'm wearing jeans now, so I can't talk, but I'm definitely more of a comfort.
No, I'm...
Really?
Jeans, definitely.
Yes.
Getting done up.
Yeah, love it. Phone calls or text messages?
Text messages.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, time efficient.
Okay, yeah, just
voice
quick,
notes
does the job. Voice notes are always a winner, aren't they?
100%.
Always a winner. Summer or winter?
Summer. Yeah, I'm
summer baby.
I'm from Guyana.
Exactly, you have to be.
Do you know what I mean?
Well, Sam, thank you so much for coming on.
No
and
problem.
A game date with me. I hope you enjoyed it.
Thanks for having me again. It was interesting. I'm glad to see that I'm still half decent at FIFA.
You've still got it.
You don't lose it.
Well, I feel like you need to come back. I know you're in retirement with the whole FIFA thing, but for me, you can have another game. Maybe you can be my practice.
Maybe you can maybe invest in SmackDown versus Raw, maybe a wrestling game.
Yeah.
Probably.
You're really showing your age now. I mean, I used to watch it, but WWE. Okay. Go for NBA, a bit of NBA, GTA.
Mario Kart?
Yeah, sure.
Mario Kart. Let's do Mario Kart.
Deal. Let's do it. Well, thank you so much
again. No problem. Thanks for having me.
I'm Serena Ulsi. This has been Sam Cox on Game Dates.